In this tutorial, I'm going to be showing you guys how you can take your photographs in stereoscopic 3D. Now, this isn't just an effect. This is going to be real 3D with an actual 3D effect that you can see using these Anaglyph old school red and blue glasses. So if you've got a pair of these, pop them on now because there'll be a 3D image right after the intro. Hi guys, I'm Ben from AdaptLux, and today we're taking our macro photographs into the third dimension. This is actually a really easy technique that you can easily apply to almost any photograph, be it macro or landscape or portrait, and I'll be explaining exactly how you can do that in this video. Before we get onto that though, we need to talk about these old school 3D glasses that I've got on my head. These ones I bought from Amazon, they're just really cheap, but you might have some of the old school paper ones lying around from the early days of viewing things in 3D. All of these are still going to work. You just need to have a red filter over the left eye and a blue filter over the right eye, and you'll be able to see all of the images in today's video in 3D with the full 3D effect. I'll put a timer up in the top corner of the screen, counting down to when there's going to be a 3D image. So if you've got some 3D glasses, you can pop them on and off, ready to see the full 3D effect. I'm going to go and set up some flowers and start taking some pictures. I've grabbed myself a whole bunch or several bunches of different types of flowers. Now, why flowers? Well, we're a macro channel, so I like getting really close up to things. So if you enjoy macro and close-up photography, make sure to subscribe for lots more tutorials just like this one. Flowers are also very deep and very, very detailed. So this is going to make for really nice 3D image. All of these petals sticking out in different directions means that we can shoot from the side of the flower and also deeper into the flower to maximize that 3D effect of things sticking out towards the viewer. I'm going to go and put some of my flowers into a clamp and compose my first shot. The setup and composition for these shots is pretty simple. There's no big tricks to setting everything up. I've got my camera down here on a tripod, and on top of that I've got a two-directional macro focus rail. That bit is quite important, and I'll talk about that in just a while. On top of that I've got my Sony a7 III and a Takino 100mm f2.8 macro lens on the front of that, which allows me to get nice and close but also move back and get my whole flower in the frame if I want to. That's what I'm doing right now. I'm going to start quite far out and move a little bit closer in. Over here I do have my flower sat at a slight angle with my lighting over here. This is the AdaptLux Studio, and I've got two white lighting arms with two diffusers attached to the end, just giving some nice soft lighting on the front of my flower. Again, nothing too drastic there, nothing too weird, a pretty straightforward setup so far. My flower is at an angle though, and that is quite important because if you're shooting straight onto the front of your flower, there's not a lot of depth there. I want this angle so that we've got something quite deep into the frame and something quite close to the camera. What this means is that our depth of field is going to get in the way. And that brings me on to the importance of our two-directional macro rail here. Obviously, this would usually be used for photo stacking or focus stacking. If you're a landscape or portraiture photographer, you don't need to worry about this too much because you're not really battling with your depth of field all that much. But when you get close up, and the closer you get, the shallower your depth of field becomes. This is sort of a battle when we're trying to get a photograph of a very deep subject to make the most of our 3D effect, and it's a battle that we're going to lose without photo stacking. Getting really close up to a deep subject with a shallow depth of field means most of your image is going to be out of focus, and that's not great even for a normal image, let alone a 3D one. So we are going to be focus stacking with our macro rail, but that's not the only use for it. We're also going to be using the other direction to move the camera from side to side. This is one of the integral parts of a 3D photograph. I've got my 3D glasses out again to explain a little bit about how Anaglyph Stereoscopic 3D actually works. What we're trying to do is deliver different images to each eye. The colours in the glasses are going to filter out the images and deliver them to the correct eye, and then our brains will do the heavy lifting with blending those images back together, creating the 3D effect in our heads. It's the same way that our depth perception works with our actual eyes. The difference in the distance between our eyes and the viewing angle onto the subject is what can create that illusion of depth and the perception of how close things are or how far things are away from us. What we're going to be doing with our camera is replicating that distance between our eyes. That's why we need to move the camera ever so slightly to get a slightly different viewing angle. Now, the actual angle of our camera doesn't need to change, only the distance between the two shots. So that's why we're using the macro focus rail. I don't want to change the angle of the lens. I don't want to change the zoom of the lens. All I want to do is move the camera, move the shot ever so slightly. This distance is pretty negligible for macro shots, only a couple of centimeters. If you're shooting larger subjects like landscapes or people, you can move up to maybe a couple of feet. The distance varies quite a lot depending on the type of shot you're doing and how large your subject is. So definitely experiment with different distances and maybe take a few shots over a few different distances, a few different movement points. You can then blend them all together later on in Photoshop and pick the one that works the best. And now it comes to actually taking our 3D image. The method I'm using here is going to involve photo stacking, but if you want to just try this effect out, you can absolutely skip the photo stacking, as long as you understand that a lot of that depth, a lot of the interesting detail in the background and the foreground might be lost because of your depth of field. If you give it a go and you think that it needs to be sharper, you can try focus stacking like I'm about to do. What I'm doing here is starting off focused on the deepest part of my image, and I'm going to be moving my camera backwards, taking photographs at different intervals. When I've got the full depth of my flower in a full stack, I'm going to move my camera a couple of centimeters to the right using the sideways motion on my focus rail. And that leaves me with my focus now set on the closest part of my flower. I can then focus stack back in the other direction to create a second stack for the other eye. This should leave me with two stacks of images to blend together to create two perfectly sharp images, one for the left eye, one for the right eye, that we can then blend together to create our 3D image. So I've imported all of my images and I've got my two stacks processed through Helicon Focus, which has left me with two really lovely sharp images of my flower. I've got a right eye image and a left eye image, and I've named them appropriately so that we can keep track of which is which. This is going to be important in a moment, so make sure you keep track during your processing of which stack of images was taken from which position. You can actually tell with my two because my left eye image here has a little bit of the AdaptLook Studio in the left hand corner here, but when we shifted the camera off to the right, it fell out of the frame. So I know that this is the right hand image meant for the right eye. Now we need to get both of these files onto the same image and we need to blend them together. So the first thing that I'm going to do is double click on my background layer on the right hand image, and I'm going to call this right. We then can go to our left eye image and I'm just going to click and drag that over to a second layer on the right eye image. We can then go ahead and close the left eye. I'm going to name this new layer left so that we keep track of which is which. Now this is where the magic happens, because we need to blend these two layers together. You can see that nothing's actually happening here at the moment. It's just two images that are covering each other. I'm going to select my left layer and double click to bring up the layer style panel. In here we have blending options and we're looking for the channels. Now this is how we're going to create the two different colors for our glasses to filter out. If you take a look at the left hand lens in your glasses from your perspective, you'll see that it's the red lens. So that's only going to let through red light.
For our left hand image, then, we need to have only red showing on this particular layer, so we can turn off the green and the blue channels. You can see that that's already had an effect. You can hit OK on that layer styling panel. As you can see, we've now got this left layer is purely red. However, the layer behind it still has all of its color, so we need to do something about that. I'm going to do the same thing again on the right hand layer, but this time I'm turning off only the red channel. This leaves my right hand image looking a little bit blue. Now we need to align them, and you can see as I begin to align them again, the color starts to come back. Now the color is not going to be perfect here, but we just need to align it enough for our 3D effect to take hold. This is where you need to pop on your 3D glasses, and as soon as you do that, you should be able to see a little bit of 3D. If it's not looking 3D, chances are you've got your layers mixed up and you turned off the channels on the wrong one. So just flip those over, and if it looks a little bit more 3D, then you've got it right this time. Now we need to align these two layers. The way that we're going to do that is to pick a focal point in our image. Where does the eye get drawn to? Where's the most important part of this flower? I'm going to say it's around here. This is where everybody's going to look for that detail of the pollen inside the flower. What I'm going to do is pick a point on my petals here, and I'm going to move everything around a little bit. As I do that with my glasses on, I can see little shadows appearing in different places. If you've not got your glasses on, you'll see these as red and blue borders where the two images aren't aligning. I'm going to fiddle with this just for a moment to try and find the perfect spot for this particular focal point. If you're wearing your 3D glasses, you should see the moment when it clicks into place and everything starts to look a little bit more normal. Now, this isn't going to apply across the entire image. The misalignment of the different areas, the different depths of your subject is actually what's creating the 3D effect. So you can't both align these petals over here and these petals over here. You need to pick that one point and then choose that as the center of your image. I think that's pretty good looking for the alignment of my two images, so now we need to think about cropping them. Taking my glasses off again, I can see that we've got a little bit of a border around here where the two images aren't quite matching up anymore, so I'm just going to hit crop, and I'm going to pick quite a close crop on here, I think, making sure not to add in any extra space where the two images don't align. I think that looks pretty good. Just one final check with my glasses. If you move your head around, you should be seeing some interesting 3D effects where the deeper areas of the image start to warp around the place. So that's a good check for how to check that you're actually getting some 3D effects going before you hit save. This 3D effect is a little bit hit and miss. It won't work for every single photograph. It won't work for every single subject. For example, the back shot of this flower here, it's quite bright. It's got a lot of orange colors in here. And although I processed it in exactly the same way as the front image here, it doesn't have that same impactful 3D effect. I think this is down to the fact that these petals on the back of my flower aren't really overlapping in the same way as they are on the front. You see here we have the depth, but we also have the overlapping layers. So you can see that these bits of the petals are quite far in front of these ones. And the same here, there's a big jump between the different layers of the image. Whereas here we still have the full depth of the image overall, but these petals are spaced quite closely together. So there really isn't that same amount of difference between the foreground and the background in each layer. I definitely think it's worth trying out as many different angles and subjects as you can, especially if you're going to be focus stacking anyway and spending a lot of time doing that. You might as well add another stack to your list and see what it looks like in 3D as well.
I'd love to know down in the comments how many of you guys have actually followed along in 3D on this video using 3D glasses, whether you already had some lying around for nostalgia purposes or whether you've been out to buy some and whether or not you've tried this type of photography before. Put it down in the comments. I'd be really interested to know whether this type of photography is just a bit of a novelty and it's truly died out, or whether it's maybe going to make a comeback at some point. Just let me know. If you enjoyed the tutorial, make sure to hit the like button on the video and subscribe for more tutorials just like this one coming in the future. That is all that I've got time for now though, guys. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you next time.